हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर सिविक्स क्लास। टुडे वी स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 6, रूलर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। यू हैव लर्न दैट द डेमोक्रेटिक गवर्नमेंट इज सेलेक्टेड फॉर 5 ईयर्स एंड इट इज़ द पॉसिबल दैट अ डिफरेंट सेट ऑफ पीपल विल कम टू रूल द कंट्री आफ्टर एवरी 5 ईयर्स। बट मैनी एस्केप्स ऑफ रिकॉर्ड्स, लॉ एंड ऑर्डर एंड अदर एस्केप्स ऑफ रूटीन लाइफ कैन नॉट स्टॉप और चेंज एवरी 5 ईयर्स। Therefore, there is a system of administration which is permanent in nature. While individual may be shifted, moved and changed, the administration continues to function. In this chapter, we shall see how the administration works in rural area. Now, let's come on our learning objects. Learning objective of this chapter is, first, district administration. Second one, organization of district administration, police, land revenue, पटवारी, तहसीलदार, डिस्ट्रिक्ट कलेक्टर एंड नेक्स्ट वन, मेंटेनेंस ऑफ सिविल अम्यूनिटीज एंड इक्वलिटी टू वुमेन। द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन हैज़ द फॉलोइंग मेन फंक्शन: टू मेंटेन लॉ एंड ऑर्डर, टू इंश्योर ऑल रिकॉर्ड्स एंड प्रॉपर्टी मेंशंस दैट वुड दिस वुड बी रिकॉर्डेड ऑन लैंड प्रॉपर्टीज, बर्थ, डेथ, एजुकेशन एंड सो ऑन। टू प्रोवाइड and maintain the standard of civic amenities like health, education, water and electricity supply, infrastructures development project, rescues and relief in case of calamity, collection of taxes and revenue. You learn that the government started from the people in the village. Administration involves control and supervision and therefore is formed top downwards. District is the basic level of administration of the rural area. District administration. The district magistrate or the DM is the highest executive officer at the district level. He or she is responsible for smooth administration in the whole of the district. He is also called the district collector and deputy commissioner. He performs the functions enumerated above with the help of many officers. There are basically 3 arms of district administration. Number one, the law and order. Second, maintenance of land records and collections of land revenue. Third one, maintenance of civil amenities and development. An organization. This is the district administration organization. Let us take a brief look of their functioning. First, we start from police. The police in our district look after the law and order escapes. There are various police stations in our district. The police stations are of different levels and have their area of jurisdictions. The strength of the police force in a district can vary depending on the area and prevailing law and order situations. Their duty is to prevent crime and ensure that the people live a safe life in their area of responsibility. Anyone who has complained about being harmed by way of bodily injury, stolen property, robbery or cheating can approach the police station with his or her complaints. The police is a duty bound to investigate the matter and bring the guilty to book. Even if a person feels threatened by someone, he or she can seek protection from the police. The police is also responsible to ensure that no one disturbs normal peace. They take steps to check entry and exit routes in fair, market and keep watch and the anti-social elements. They are supposed to keep a vigil during festivals so that there is no trouble by the miscertain. The police maintains a jail at the district level. Anyone who commits a crime can be jailed by the magistrate. The police then ensure that the criminal remains in jail for the period of his or her punishment. The police has a lockup or a cell in the police station where they can keep a suspected criminal for a short period till such time the investigation are on. Now we come on next second point, land and revenue. The maximum disputes among the people living in a society are due to the ownership of land. Every person wishes to own some land to live on, to live or to cultivate it for food and another income. Land is costly and it causes lot of dispute to arise. There are fight between members of the family on sharing land, especially at the time of inheritance. The government also collects revenue from the owner, which is based on the land owned by agriculture purpose. It is therefore important to maintain records on land of land ownership. Patwari. The maintenance of land records and collection of revenue is a major function of administration. The land and revenue collection is done by revenue officer, and at the basic village level, a nominate employee of the revenue department maintains all record of land ownership. Such person is known as a patwari. The patwari is known by the other name in different regions like likpal, karamchari, etc. Here are the duties of patwari. First, to maintain a detailed map of the area. Second, to measure and divide into the part called khasra. To measure, mark and record the ownership of land on a map. Use a tool of chain and link to measure land. To update the record as and when it is the subdivided on or the ownership is changed. To maintain a separate record, common land of the village, which is the grazing, festival, etc. No one is allowed to crop on this public land. To keep a record of crop grown on the various patches of land. To give information to district officials about quality and quantity of crops so that the revenue can be charged. To collect the revenue from the owners of land. To inform the district authorized in case there is failure of crop due to flood or famine, etc. Now come on, Tehsildar. The functioning of the patwari is supervised at the next level, tehsil, taluka, by the tehsildar. The tehsildar is the revenue officer at the tehsil level, which has many villages under it. This level is subdivision of the district. The tehsildar ensure that the records are mentioned properly and the revenue collection is deposited with the government. He is also hear the dispute of land at his office and give his judgment after verification of records maintained by the patwari. Next one is the district collector. Next level. The highest level of land and revenue for rural area is the district headquarter. The district collector or the district magistrate is responsible for all the revenue and land related escapes in the district. Here are the responsibility of a district collector. Responsibility of the district collector. Number 1. To ensure the correct functioning of all tehsildar and patwari in the district. Second, to hear all land disputes and to judge the same. To ensure that the revenue is collected in time and deposited with the government. To assess and give recommendation to the government on the matter of compensation in case of crop failure or flood or famine. To provide rescues and relief in case of a calamity in the district. Next point, maintenance of civil amenities. The district administration headed by the district magistrate or the district collector has another function to ensure that the civil amenities are provided to the people in the district. He has many officers who look after their respective department and are answerable to the district collector if there is any inefficiency in their department. A few examples are, first one is the public works department. This is looked after the executive engineer who look after the maintenance of government building, roads and other infrastructures. Next, health department. This is the under of supervision of the civil surgeons or chief medical officer who look after dispensaries, hospitals and other health needs of the population. Next one, education department. The district education officer is responsible to ensure that all schools in the districts are run efficiently and properly. The attendance of the teacher and provisions of buildings and other facilities. Next topic, last one, equality of women. The Indian Democratic Government realized that people in India preferred a male child. The women here were discriminated against, the left to fend for themselves in crisis. They did not get any share from the property of the parents. To ensure equal status to women in the society, the law of inheritance was amended in 2005, which gave women equal rights in property of their father. This was aimed to help in giving them more option of livelihood if they were married or widow. This act also aimed to reduce domestic violence. It also led to giving the women a greater sense of economic self-dependency and security. Highlights of Hindu Sessions Act, Amendment 2005. The Hindu Session Amendment Act 2005 came into effect from 9 September 2005. The Government of India has issued notification to this effect. The Hindu Session Act is to remove gender discriminatory provisions in the Hindu Sessions Act 1956. The highlighting features of the amendment are: number 1, the daughter will be treated as equal in all respect as the son in the eye of law, inheritance, or of property and land. The daughter, whether married or unmarried, is allowed the same share as in allotted to a son. In case of daughter has died, her share of property would go to the children. So this is the main point of Hindu Session Act of 2005. Now complete this chapter. Thank you for watching.